Silva. Eric, Jonathan, anywhere, really. Welcome. So we started this thing. I really wanted you to do the introduction with us, because it happened really fast that actually last year exactly I was at the Founders Forum that Brent organizes in a few days, and we went to number 10. So Jonathan and Rohan, you organized a meeting there, and Mr. Cameron greeted me saying, you need to move LeWeb to London, which was very interesting. I was very impressed on how you guys briefed him or told him, and you made it happen. So Brent, the idea came from you and all my friends and participants and speakers who told me you should really do something in London. So why did you want LeWeb in London, Brent?
London needs to claim its rightful place as the heart of the European ecosystem, and you were doing too good a job for Paris. So we need to show everyone who'd been to Paris what can be done in London that there is, and it's also an amazing place to visit. So I think what you found as well is that a lot of people from all over the world are very happy to come here. So we think, right, let's get this ecosystem moving. And it all fits in with what our Prime Minister said yesterday at the G20, is that we are opening a nice red carpet on your iPad, a red carpet to any French entrepreneurs who may be trapped by Monsieur Hollande's policies.
I won't comment on this one, and I have no idea what Brent...
I don't think I was quoting him word for word, by the way. That wasn't word for word.
Okay, well, thank you, Brent. Rohan, can you explain why entrepreneurs should move here?
Yeah, well, I think London is a lot like LeWeb right now. It's full of energy, it's full of ideas, it's full of French entrepreneurs, which is great. And I think that just like LeWeb, and as Loic said, the Prime Minister really keen that LeWeb comes to London, so proud that this is happening right now. But just like LeWeb with government support, so too does entrepreneurship in London, so too does technology in London have big government support. And, you know, over the last couple of years, we've really been listening to what entrepreneurs and tech investors have been saying to us. They've been saying, we need more generous tax breaks for angel investment. So we now have the most generous early stage tax breaks in the world. They've been saying, you need a radical open data agenda. And so we've been driving that through too. They said, you need an entrepreneur visa. You need to open up government procurement. You know, we're really listening and we're really acting. And, you know, all of you here, entrepreneurs thinking of moving to London, come and talk to us. We'll be around the conference, all four of us, over the next couple of days. Any ideas you've got, any complaints, we're here to listen and we're here to help and we're here to act. So thank you.
And is it a chance, someone asked on Twitter, I don't know if you saw those of you who took the Eurostar, there is a huge ad, UKTI with Richard Branson, and it's like move to London, right? Is that the chance that you guys are doing things like this?
Yeah. Well, look, that is actually Jonathan's post.
In Paris, by the way. Jonathan, you want to comment on that? This is pretty aggressive.
I take responsibility for that, Loic. I mean, we wanted to, you know, there's some pretty amazing stuff happening this year in London, whether it's the Diamond Jubilee or the 2012 London Cultural Festival or the Olympics and the Paralympic Games. It's a great year. But we wanted 2012 to be about more than just great sport, great culture, great heritage. We wanted it to be about great innovation, great technology, great entrepreneurship, great enterprise. And so, you know, that poster symbolizes what we think. It sort of shows off what we want to show off to the world, that this is a great year.
And you have this all around Europe? Because when you see it in Paris, frankly, it's kind of interesting.
They're all around the world. I mean, hopefully people who've traveled here from San Francisco or Boston or Shanghai or Hong Kong, they'll have seen those same images. We really want to make sure everyone knows that this is a really great year in Britain.
Excellent. Eric, you helped us with your team. It's been incredible. We've put this together in you know, a little bit more than 3 months. Can you explain what your role is and why did you want so much this thing to happen here?
Well, I could, but actually what I'd really like to do first is, can I just ask everybody to quickly put their hands together and a huge thank you to Loic and Geraldine for making this possible. You guys rock. You really, really do. Absolutely awesome. So my role is a very small part of the whole operation, in that it's part of the Tech City initiative. We're very fortunate that London has this new narrative, this new story, which is the fastest growing tech and digital and creative cluster in Europe. And our job is really just to amplify what's going on in the cluster and to make sure it has all the right ingredients necessary to grow, and otherwise mostly try and stay out of the way, which we do our best to try to do. And actually, can I just mention something we're doing today? I know I'm taking over.
That's why I have you here today.
So one of the things that's really important is that Loic brings with him an extraordinary group of investors and CEOs from all around the world. And one thing we decided to do at this LeWeb, and I hope to see you do it at future LeWebs, is something called Office Hours. Office Hours is a terrific concept that's quite common in Silicon Valley. And what it is world-class investors and CEOs coming to spend regular time, say, you know, last Thursday of each month. And you come along as an entrepreneur, as a startup, you just take a ticket and grab a seat, and you get to chat with them for 10, 15 minutes and to get some direction from people who really understand that. So we're doing that here. We've got the UKTI Office Hours Surgery. We decided to call it surgery as well, so it works both ways. And you have very kindly arranged some amazing people to actually attend that. So Shaq Khan, MJ Siegler, Kevin Rose is going to be there, Anil Hansji, Eric Archambault, Alex McCracken, Matthias Lungman, Zachary Sims, Renaud Laplan, Saul Klein, Peter Reed, Julia Hartz, it goes on. And
amazing investors. And amazing any investors. Of you can go and...
Can you tell them where it is?
Yes, it's for those of you online, it's going to be more complicated. But for those of you in the room, you just follow the signs to the UKTI lounge. It's pretty easy.
So from 10:30 to 5 each day, you don't need an appointment. You just got to go up to the second floor, look for the UKTI lounge, register to get your slot, and you get to see one of these guys.
Who will give you a clinic about your business. That's such a cool idea. Brent, how is the? Can you talk about the London ecosystem? Because you've been so active here for years.
Well, I think obviously, I think you know many of you here will know it as well, but will have seen that it is definitely more dynamic. Gosh, I mean, if you don't look back, but 98 when we were around, it was pretty rare to find two kids and a business plan raising even $1 million, which is what our old boss said to us. You've got to be nuts to think the two of you, Martha and I, could just raise $1 million with a business plan in 98. Now, hopefully, as everyone's seeing, there are more and more people doing that. What's happening is that there was this wave of big exits, as we all know, in sort of 2000, from 2000 to 2005, and many of those entrepreneurs are still around, and they are reinvesting in the ecosystem. I think that's a big change. It's something that we've seen in...
So Niklas Zennström and who else?
Niklas Zennström.
Yourself, Josh, you invest a lot too, right?
We have ProFounders Capital with Michael Birch from Bebo. We have Joss and Ben White with Notion. And there's quite a longer list, and there's a few more coming. I've seen a few more are in the pipeline, raising more $50 million funds. So these are the guys who are investing in that very early stage, which is where people say it's hardest. And there are initiatives.
How can we pitch you? Because you have a lot of entrepreneurs today.
Well,
what are you looking for? Like
Brent at profounderscapital.com. And it is for we do £500,000 to £1.5 million is our sweet spot, early stage internet. And we've done businesses like mydeco, which I chair, but that one's doing pretty well, and One Fine Stay, which is a differentiated. We do like different ideas. In an ideal world, we wouldn't do any copycats, a big theme we have, but I can't say that's the purity is pretty
You don't
hard.
Like copycats in Europe, right? Do you?
I don't like copycats because you're not shooting for the stars, right? If you want to build, if we want more autonomies and companies with $10 billion, you're not going to get that by copying someone else's business and just selling out to them. If you're a
And you're not referring to anyone when you say that, right?
No, not to our good friends, no. this is streamed, Loic. They may not be here, but it is streamed. I'm not going to fall for that.
Okay, very good. Well, can you comment about how, the startup and all the three of you, whomever wants, but what you're doing with Tech City and the entrepreneurs here and how London is shaping up, because it's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I think something really special is happening in this part of London, in East London. And I think the reason that something cool is going on there is that it's not some kind of arid business park in the middle of nowhere. It's a place where artists and fashion designers and creators are coming together with technology companies. So it's an incredible place to live and work. And any of you who haven't been to that part of London, to East London, to Shoreditch, Old Street. While you're here, do go along and take a look. Something really great is happening, and we're trying to do the right things as a government in terms of infrastructure and transport and planning, as well as the right tax policies and so on, to really get behind it and make it, as Brent says, the place in Europe to go.
Jonathan, do you invest in startups too?
I wish I was in that position, Loic.
Oh, but the government could invest, right?
Of course, yeah. The government's doing everything it can, as Rohan was saying, to create the conditions for increased investment in early stage companies, in startups. There's always more we can do, as Rohan was saying. You know, one of the reasons that we're so happy that you've brought this amazing crowd here to London is it gives us yet another opportunity to get feedback, to understand where we can make some improvements. We're constantly trying to make improvements. We welcome that feedback.
Is it competition in Europe that is that I is think, that good for Europe?
I think that is good.
Do you work with your friends in other countries? Unlike Brent is saying, I bet you.
You've had Nicolas Princen on your stage before at LeWeb. Yeah. Nicolas was working, doing great things at L'Elysée, and I'm sure the new government will try and follow in his footsteps. But it's good to have some competition between European countries, as long as there's a level digital playing field, as long as the opportunities are there for entrepreneurs, then
as long as everybody moves to London.
Well,
what? I think it's such a great arms race. So we're constantly hearing Berlin has some strengths, particularly cheap property, and so we go out and we say to companies, hey, can you create incubator spaces, cheap, flexible spaces for startups? And Google have built a 7-story building in East London that hasn't got Google people in it. It's just for entrepreneurs, startups to base themselves out of. And I really think that they wouldn't have done that, and we wouldn't have done that, had it not been for Berlin. So I think that kind of competition, that kind of arms race, is really healthy. And if any of you have thoughts on which cities are doing good things that we need to play catch up with, we really want to hear that.
Eric, you're an entrepreneur yourself, right?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
And you work for the government.
I know, it's weird, isn't it?
It's interesting.
You know, they say entrepreneur in residence. It really means the entrepreneur they just about tolerate. So that's really what it really means.
Yeah, I mean, you guys hire entrepreneurs. You could also invest in startups.
They're terrific, by the way. What I would also say, though, is that if anyone is here that wants to figure out how to, say, access the UK markets, if there are any startups here that are not from the UK, come to the UKTI lounge and ask us, how can I set up and, start accessing the UK markets? We have a whole team designed to help you be successful. Actually, that's the only thing I would ask people. Could we just do one thing for us? Be massively successful as a result of this, and then let us know how it went for you, and ask us to help.
Absolutely, and I can testify how your team is efficient in helping small events to move to do another one in London. We'll do it in Paris, of course, December 4, 5, 6. Brent, some final words, and we move on to our next session.
Final words. Well, I think what's great is that in this arms race that we've spoken about, is that it's the countries that learn. It's like a startup. If a country sees itself like a startup and says, we're going to learn from what others are doing, we're going to adapt, not copy, but learn, and take it and do one better, then that's the approach that I think we are seeing from this government in the UK. And that's what, when we were at last year's Founders Forum, I think people, all those entrepreneurs, many of them blogged about it later, when they heard the Prime Minister speak, my God, he actually gets it. This is a country where the Prime Minister gets it, and they really are. It's not just rhetoric. I mean, what's interesting, it's an arms race of rhetoric, too. Everybody's saying, we love entrepreneurs, it's growth is all going to come from entrepreneurs. But it's actually, what are the actions that are being taken? And I think that's the key thing that we're going to see in the next few years, is hopefully the impact of the actions of these guys.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for all your help, and please do visit the UKTI lounge to get your clinic with the best entrepreneurs and investors. Thank you. And we'll see you around. All day. Thank you very much.